Hello guys, my name is Ashish and welcome to the Java tutorial series. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the arithmetic operator and the unary operator in Java. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the assignment operator in Java in detail with a proper example. So guys, I will suggest you to watch the lecture till the end. And guys, before starting the lecture, I request you all to subscribe the XAdmin channel to get notification whenever a new lecture is uploaded. And guys, please hit the like button at the end so that it will encourage me to bring more awesome videos for you guys. So guys, let's start on the assignment operator. So guys, assignment operator. Equal to assignment operator is used to assign a value to any variable. It has right to left associativity. That means the value given on right hand side of the operator is assigned to the variable on the left hand side. Therefore, right hand side value must be declared. Okay guys, before using it or should be constant. So guys, the assignment operator is used to assign a value to any variable, right? It has a right to left associativity, means the value given on right hand side of the operator is assigned to the variable on the left hand side, and therefore the right hand side value must be declared before using it, right? So guys, the general format of the assignment operator is like variable equals to value. So guys, in the left hand side variable is written, and in the right side the value is taken. So guys, assignment is possible in the following cases, like the when the destination and the source both are of same type, when destination is larger data type to the source, and when the destination is a small type and the source is of larger type, then in that case the assignment is not allowed directly. You need to perform the typecasting to its corresponding compatibility data type, right guys? For example, byte b1 equals to 10, int i1 equals to 10, byte b11 equals to b1. Here we can assign b1 to b11 because b1 is of byte type, right? And the next is int i11 equals to i1. Here we are able to assign i1 to i11 because as the i1 and i11 both are of integer type. Next is int i12 equals to b1. Now guys, here we are able to assign the b1 to i12 because byte is smaller than integer type. That's why we can able to assign the b1 to b12. And the next is byte b12 equals to i1. So guys, here we are not able to assign directly i1 because the i1 is integer type and the b12 is of byte type. So guys, here we have to use the type casting. So guys, we have to do the type casting here, then only we can use it. Okay guys, so next is, in many cases assignment operator can be combined with the other operator to build a short version of the statement called as compound statements. In many cases assignment operators can be combined with other operators to build a shorter version of the statement called the compound statement. For example, instead of a equals to a plus b, right guys, we can also write a plus equals to b. So guys, a plus equals to 5 and a equals to a plus 5. So guys, these both are the same, right guys? So guys, for example, plus equals to, for adding left operand with the right operand and then assigning it to the variable on the left, right guys? So guys, here a plus equals to 5, it is equal to a equals to a plus 5. So guys, a will get added to 5 and then it will assign to variable a. So guys, here the minus equals to, for subtracting left operand with the right operand and then assigning it to the variable on the left. In the same way, multiply equals to, for multiplying left operand with the right operand and then assigning it to the variable on the left hand side, right guys? In the same way, divide equals to, for dividing left operand with the right operand and then assigning it to the variable on the left operand. In the same way guys, module equals to, for assigning module to the left operand with the right operand and then assigning into the variable on the left operand. So guys, these are the sum of the shorter versions of using the statement. So guys, it is also called as compound statement, right guys? So in this so guys in this we have seen the assignment operator, like equals to. So guys, there are the rules, like the when the destination and the source both are of same type, when the destination is larger data type to the source, and when the destination is smaller type and the source is larger type, then we have to do the type casting. So guys, this is very important for the assignment, otherwise it will give us a compile time error, right guys? So guys, next we are going to see how to implement this assignment operator in our Java program. So guys, let's move to the program and directly we can see that. So guys, here I am going to delete all the variables and inside the so operation method. So guys, I am going to keep a equals to 2, b equals to 10, c equals to 0, d equals to 20, and here I am going to do c as a. So guys, I am not going to assign any value to the c and d, and also to the. Okay, guys, e equals to 40, f equals to 30, and one more, g equals to 90, right guys? So guys next I am going to do a simple assignment operator. Simple assignment operator, that means c equals to b. So guys, this is a simple assignment operator. I am using simple assignment operator, and guys, I am going to do this SOP, and I am going to write as value of c, right guys? Value of c as c. Okay guys, so guys, in the next I am going to do c equals to d. So guys, now I am going to do c equals to d. So guys, here we can see that c equals to d, right guys? And I am going to SOP the value c. So guys, I have done this. So guys, in the next I am going to do like a equals to a plus 1 and b equals to b plus 1 and e equals to e into 1, and guys, in the same way I am going to take f equals to f dividing 2, right? F is 30, so it is going to divide with 30. And now inside the SOP, I'm going to take all the values as, and I'm going inside the value of A as A, and the value of B in the same way, value of the E in the same way, value of F is F, right guys? So guys next I am going to use the shortened statement. Okay guys, so for guys, a shortened statement, like I am going to delete the previous one, c equals to e minus 1. Now, so guys, now we can see the shortened path. Shortened statement, right guys? Spelling is wrong. STATEMENT, statement, right? So guys, a plus equals to 1, right guys? Equal to 1 is like, it is equals to like a equals to a plus 1. Okay guys, so guys, this a equals to a plus 1 and a plus equals to 1 is same. Okay guys, so in the next line I am going to do b minus equals to 1. In the same way, b equals to b minus 1. This is the same, and the b minus equals to 1 and b equals to b minus 1 is same. So guys, in the same way, I'm going to do e multiply equals to 2, and in the same way f dividing equals to 2. Okay guys, and in the next I'm going to do the SOP of all the values, like the value of a is a. So guys, I'm going to copy and paste this SOPs, right guys? So guys, a value of a, b, e and f, right guys? And now guys, I'm going to compile this class and we are going to see the output. Output of this is like, so guys, one by one we are going to see. The output is the SOP of value of C is C. So C equals to B. So B is 10. So C equals to 10. Right, guys? So next is the value of A is A. So guys, A value is here A equals to A plus 1. So A was 2. So 2 plus 1 is 3. So A equals to 3. In the same way, B is 11. So guys, B equals to B plus 1. So B was 10, so 10 plus 1 is 11. So next, e equals to e into 1. So e was 40 into 1, 40. So e 40. So guys, f dividing 2. So f was 30 dividing 2, we should get 15. So guys, we are getting 15, right guys? In the same way, we are going to see the shorthand statement, like a plus equals to 1. So a equals to a plus 1. So a was, so guys, here the a was 3, so we are getting 4, right guys? So here we can see a was 3, so a equals to 4. So now guys, b minus equals to 1. So guys, b was 11, so here we are getting 11 minus 1, 10. So 10, right guys? In the same way, e into 2. So guys, e was 40 into 2, 80, right guys? So we are getting 80. The next, f dividing 2. So guys, f was 15. So by dividing 2, we are getting 7, right guys? So this is a small example for the assignment operator, right guys? So here guys, we have seen a small example which is showing us the or how to use all the assignment operator, and we have seen also the shorthand statement also. So guys, this is very important. We can use in our program the shorthand statement also. So guys, this is a very small program for showing the operator, like the assignment operator. So guys, directly we are jumping to the slide, and we are going to move ahead. So guys, here we can see, so guys next is the type casting. So guys, the type casting is the process of converting one data type to the another data type with its compatibility range. So guys, there are two type of type casting. The first is the explicit type casting or narrowing, and the implicit type casting and the widening, right guys? So there are two type of type casting. First is explicit type casting and second is implicit type casting. Explicit type casting, in this type casting, when the destination is smaller and the source is larger, then in that case we need to perform the type casting to its required destination type, right guys? Explicit type casting is required when the destination is small and the source is larger than the destination, right guys? So guys, for example, data type variable name equals to data type inside the bracket and the variable name. So guys, if the variable name 1 is larger than the here the variable name 1 data type is larger than the variable name data type, then we are going to type cast to the variable name data type, right guys? Here the destination is smaller. This is destination and this is source. So guys, source is larger than the destination, then we have to do the type casting, right guys? I hope you understand the concept for the explicit type casting. So guys, explicit type casting is used when the destination is smaller and the source is larger. So guys, here the variable name one is of larger data type. It means, for example, I can say that here, like the byte b12 equals to i1. So guys, we have seen that the i1 is of integer type and b12 variable is of byte type. So guys, here the source is the i1. So i1 is of larger data type than the byte. So guys, here we are getting we will get a compile time error. So guys, here we have to do the type casting. So guys, here byte b1 equals to byte in bracket and then i1. So guys, this is explicit type casting. Here we are doing this type casting, means we are converting the integer data type to the byte data type and we are storing in the byte data type, right guys? So this is explicit type casting. Next is implicit type casting. In this case, the destination is larger than the source, so in that case we need not to typecast explicitly. It will automatically be done by the JVM in the destination data type, right guys? So guys, for example, int I equals to b1, here it is implicit data type. So guys, here the implicit data type is done by the JVM itself. So guys, here like the b1 is of byte data type and integer I variable. So guys, we are going to store the value of the b1, which is of byte type, to the integer I. So guys, here the b1 is smaller data type than the integer I, and guys, here the source is smaller, right guys, than the destination, right guys? So guys, here the destination is larger than the source. So guys, we don't have to do anything. All the things will be done by the JVM. It will convert into the to the destination type. So guys, this is example of the implicit data type. So guys, we can also write this as integer i2 integer b1. So guys, this is the same, or we can write integer I equals to b1. So guys, this is the implicit data type. So guys, in this lecture we have seen all the type casting is of two type: explicit data type casting and the implicit data type casting, which is also known as explicit data type casting, is also known as narrowing, and the implicit data type casting is also known as widening. So guys, these terms you have to remember, right guys? Explicit type casting and the implicit type casting. Implicit type casting is done by the JVM itself, and the explicit type casting is done by the developers, right guys? So guys, we have also seen the assignment operator equal to. So guys, with an example we have seen all the assignment operator and how we can use in our program, and this is the shortened assignment assignment operators, right guys? So guys, this is all about the assignment operator. So guys, I hope you like this video on the assignment operators. And guys, in the next part of this, we are going to see the relational operator with an example. So guys, stay tuned and keep learning. So guys, thank you and have a nice day.